Imagine a platform where you can buy and sell computing resources in a decentralized marketplace. Well, Akash Network does exactly that, and in this video, we are going to find out how. Akash Network, also known by the market ticker AKT, is a blockchain-based and decentralized cloud computing platform that aims to provide a secure and open marketplace for cloud resources. It is designed to enable users to lease their idle computing resources, in this case, GPU power. Akash Network focuses heavily on AI developers and researchers who require the ability to process immense amounts of data for their machine learning algorithms. In principle, Akash aims to become the intermediary between those who need large quantities of GPU power and those who have a large quantity of GPU power sitting idle. I know it probably sounds complicated, but keep watching because by the end of this video, you will know what Akash Network is, how Akash works, and what the tokenomics of the AKT token are. Akash was founded by Greg and Adam, with their white paper being released in December 2017, and the Akash blockchain itself would go live in 2020. At its core, Akash Network is an open-source, cloud-based marketplace that allows users to buy and sell computing resources. Akash operates as a decentralized public utility, which includes a reverse auction system that ensures their prices are always the most competitive on the market. But how exactly does a reverse auction work? Instead of who will pay the most, it's a case of who will do the work for the least. So, say you have got $100 to spend for a certain amount of GPU power. In a reverse auction, you name your price and your requirements. For example, how much processing power you need, and then GPU power providers compete to provide the service cheaper. Maybe one GPU power provider will give you the required processing power for $90. Maybe another will do it for $80, etc. Until it reaches a floor where no one is willing to do the work for less. Ultimately, this ensures the cheapest possible price for the user, which fits with Akash's key objective of being a developer and user-centric platform first and foremost. Though, that leads us to the question, how does it all work? The Akash Network was built using the Cosmos SDK, meaning it is a proof-of-stake-based blockchain which uses the Tendermint consensus mechanism to verify its transactions and utilizes a Byzantine fault tolerance to ensure accuracy. But that is a lot of crypto buzzwords, so let's quickly get our definitions defined so we are all on the same page. First, the Cosmos Software Development Kit, or SDK, is a blockchain development framework that empowers developers to create their own customized blockchain networks. The SDK operates using a modular architecture, which allows developers to assemble and customize various components to suit their specific needs. Next, and key to its functionality, is the Tendermint consensus mechanism, which is a proof-of-stake-based consensus mechanism that provides a secure and efficient consensus. To ensure a secure and efficient consensus, Tendermint utilizes a Byzantine fault tolerance to ensure the accuracy of the data being provided to the blockchain. Byzantine fault tolerance, or BFT, is a concept in distributed systems which ensures the reliability of a network even when some nodes act maliciously or fail. BFT functions by having nodes in the network communicate and agree on a single consistent state despite potential discrepancies or malicious actions. In short, as long as at least two-thirds of the nodes are honest and agree on a value, the network can reach a consensus and continue through faults and occasional bad actors. Lastly, the Akash Network has the SDK's Inter-Blockchain Communication Protocol, or IBC protocol, enabled, which allows interoperability between different blockchains in the Cosmos ecosystem, creating a decentralized internet of independent blockchains. As you can see, the main benefit of the Cosmos SDK for developers is that this framework simplifies blockchain development, offering flexibility and scalability while maintaining security and compatibility with other blockchain networks. But as I have talked about the Cosmos SDK a few times previously, I will leave a few links in the description for anyone who would like to learn a little more next. And by the way, if you enjoy this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. Now that we know what Akash is and how it works, let's find out what makes Akash unique. Akash was the first open-source decentralized cloud platform, which is its main selling point. Though more specifically, what makes Akash truly unique is the way it has not pitched itself as a cryptocurrency just used for network payments, but pitches itself more so as a unit of measure for pricing settlements on its platform. That is because on the Akash platform, you don't need to pay in AKT for their services. There are a handful of whitelisted cryptocurrencies they are willing to accept, though AKT will be the unit of measurement for their prices, regardless of what currency you pay in, to ensure consistency for the user. Meaning, if you want to buy idle GPU power in Bitcoin, on Akash you can. In a summary, what makes Akash unique from its peers, it is a mix of all the above. It is a permissionless 24/7 decentralized cloud computing service that provides quick, cheap, and green GPU power to those who need it. But how about the tokenomics? Like most proof-of-stake-based tokens, AKT can be used for the classics of payments, staking for rewards, and governance. AKT has a maximum supply of around 388 million tokens, with 100 million being released at launch and the rest slowly being released over time. In the beginning, AKT was launched with a high level of inflation, which helped to keep the cost of service low and increased early adoption. This inflation rate is set to halve every 2 to 4 years, until 2030, when the last of the 388 million will have been released. This will lead to AKT going from an inflationary to a deflationary token as the rate of tokens being used exceeds the rate at which they are produced. Akash has managed to create a project with real-world utility and a legitimate use case and application for that end. In short, if you need GPU power for a project, Akash knows a person and they will link you up. With the demand for idle computing power only likely to increase with time, it seems possible that the best days for Akash Network may still lay ahead. Though, as always, it is wise to remember that nothing is guaranteed in crypto, of course. Thanks for watching. If you like the video on Akash Network and you want to learn more about shared computing resources, click here to watch the video on Rendered.